what was coming next, the world wasn't ready for. I mean, this dude was gonna take it to the next level, you know, towards all.
Yeah, it was a wonderful and I'm sure a scary sight when I seen you, him, and Snoop at that press conference talking about how you was gonna take all your fans and flip them into a political force. You know, that was the last thing. That was very scary.
Yeah, so I'm glad you brought that up because that's how serious it is. And to understand, David, we actually sat down and talked about that. You know what I'm saying? That we gonna, okay, Hammer, you gonna get all the Hammer fans. That's what I'm saying. That's what I was talking about. Fans, Hammer fans, and we gonna make a political movement. So when we want certain people in office, we gonna tell all our fans, this the dude that represents us. This the woman that represents us. And we were, as you know, you was at that press conference when we announced that. So, man, it was scary to a lot of people.
So scary that they don't show that. You never see that on MTV, BET, or any of those places. The news doesn't bring it up. They talk about a lot of things.
Ain't nobody never said shit. Soon as I said fuck the world wanna start tripping. So that's where I'm twisted at. You understand what I'm saying? It's like I understand. Bill Clinton could peel his dick out and don't nobody say shit. Tupac peel my dick out, everybody wanna put me in jail. I don't understand. It's not the same rules. We all have to follow the same rules. The rules have to apply to every man, woman, and child. It cannot be just for the rich or for the poor. If it is, there's gonna be war. And that's what thug life is about. I'm showing you that when you oppress a people, all we gonna do is blow up in your face. Nobody having no daddies, you know what I'm saying? And even if we do have a daddy, he's so damn tired from fighting the system, you know what I'm saying? He can't even really, like, put his hands on us and raise us. He don't even have that right as a father anymore to raise us. It's like the government want to raise all the kids. And when the government want to raise the kids and we see the government can't even run the country, the kids get to rebelling. And when we rebel, since we don't have no knowledge of what to do or how to do it, we just watch what the government do. And if we TV, kids look at the TV and hear the rappers going fuck bitch bitch and that's all they pick up. That's bullshit. We're not picking that up. That's not what we shooting for. That's not what we blowing shit up for. That's not what we're getting that from. We're not, that's not where we're grabbing our information. We're grabbing our information from watching America go to Haiti, beat the shit out of motherfuckers, kick them out their house, and then move their own people in. We're watching our America go to where's that other spot? They just came from Kuwait, just shoot motherfuckers up, bomb churches, and say it's in the name of love, and bomb, you know, schools, and bomb hospitals, and just starve whole nations. We're watching how America takes their armies, and they'll surround a whole nation so no food get there to strangle the whole nation. And the kids and everybody.
Nothing is happening, and this happens, and it's been happening, and it's happened before, and it's gonna happen again, unless brothers and sisters actually stop and realize that everything is not okay in America. You know, that don't worry, be happy. It's time that we start worrying and get angry, you know, and not angry and pick up the gun, but angry and start opening our minds, you know what I'm saying, and stop sleeping, you know. And so that's really what the Panthers are all about.
We just gotta keep going. We gotta make it better for the next generation. That's all we're doing. And it's been so fucked up. They left it to us so fucked up that we can't even give it to the next generation good. We could try to like eliminate as many as the bad things as we can. You know what I'm saying? Before we go. But in this country, a black man only have like 5 years we can exhibit maximum strength. And that's right now, while you a teenager, while you still strong, while you still want to lift weights, while you still want to shoot back. Because once you turn 30, it's like they take the heart and soul out of a man, out of a black man in this country. And you don't want to fight no more. And if you don't believe me, you can look around. You don't see no loudmouth 30-year-old motherfuckers. You only see young niggas my age talking like this. That's because at a certain age, they take your heart and soul. But what thug life is about is if that any nigga out there feel like he tired, he don't want to fight no more, I bet you if he pick up our tape and he listen to it, he gonna want to fight some more.
And at the same time, one can say that you're acting on the stereotypes.
Because it's like, if it's like, I'm seeing that as a farce, you know what I'm saying? I'm saying I'm bad, it's a farce. Because like I said, I just told you some of the atrocities that this country's been committing in front of our face. You know what I'm saying? So if I was bad, it would be more bodies. If I was this bad guy, how come ain't no corpses with my name on it? You know what I'm saying? How come it's all these corpses with their names on it? You know what I'm saying? Everywhere we go, just look in any country that ain't controlled by America and ask them what America did to them. And I bet you it's going to be some pillaging, raping, taking, snatching, beating, shooting, killing, locking up, beating down. Some shit that us thugs ain't even started doing yet. You know, the shit that I'm saying is nothing compared to what my offspring is going to feel. Trust me. Trust me. I'm just doing this so my son, my daughter don't say my daddy was a punk. You know what I'm saying? Because they see it too. They're going to see it. There's nothing I can do. I won't be able to abolish the atrocities in this country before my babies is born. But I will be able to get some shots in so they can see that their father is knocking some shit down. We was doing something. You know what I'm saying? Next election, I promise. By the next election, I promise. I'm gonna be sitting across from all the candidates. I bet you. You know how I'll be making it? I promise you. I'm not even gonna be, I'm gonna be so far from where I am now in 4 years. God willing, I'm alive. It's on. I guarantee you, we will have our own political party.
A lot of people, fans that's listening to you right now, that don't really get a chance to talk to Tupac up and close and personal like we kicked it today. But if it's anything you want people to know about Tupac, what is it you like to say?
Number one, when I diss y'all, meaning this, I mean like when you come up to me and I'm not giving you the kind of reaction that you think I should be giving you, it's not because I'm ungrateful, it's because I'm nervous, I'm paranoid, I just got out of jail, I've been shot, I've been cheated and lied and framed, and I just don't know how to deal with so many people giving me that much affection. I've never had.
Hi Tupac, how you doing? Can you tell me how you doing today?
Well, I just had to listen to the prosecution's closing argument, and it was just so far from the truth that it really just has me drained at the end of the day. But I'm leaving it in the hands of the jury. I'm learning a lot about people's innermost fears in this trial, because it's not even about my trial no more. It's just about loud rap music, tattoo having thugs. It's not even about me no more. It's about, you know, some nightmare that these people having.
She's talking about thug life and all that, trying to...
He's definitely guilty. Anybody with thug life tattooed on their stomach is guilty. What type of reasoning is that? You know what I'm saying? We got different backgrounds. We come from two different places. Just because I look different than her doesn't mean that I'm a sodomizer or a raper. They've said it in the... I can't understand why it's this close. They're talking about there's no evidence that I ever sodomized her, even though you put that all over the paper. And every time they take a quote out of this courtroom, they take a quote from out of her mouth, which is, you know, the stuff to put me in jail. It's nothing that's been true. I just want print the facts so everybody can sort it out. My life is ruined because nobody has a chance to get the facts.
And the fact is that there was no semen found.
No semen found, no forcible entry, no entry into the anal, no nothing, none of that, you know.
And no fingerprints on the gun.
No fingerprints on the guns, you know what I'm saying? The only time ever there was an act of sodomy, she admitted she did it to me. I should be, you know, putting charges on this girl who sodomized me on the floor of a dance club. Why am I in court, you know what I'm saying? Get my life ripped apart. But I'm here, I'm gonna go through it just to show that I have faith in the American system. But for me to have faith in the American system, these juries and everybody else has to, you know what I'm saying, play the same role and to keep an open mind. I'm already convicted. My whole life has been turned around. I lost every job. I lost everything, every opportunity. I can't get buy cars, can't get rent, can't get none of that. But I'm still a survivor, you know. I'm still coming to court, still smiling, still signing autographs. But soon I'm gonna go crazy. Tyson's. What? Come on, man. This is all about my image. This has nothing to do with me. This is all about my image. I'm guilty, even though the only crime I've been convicted of is fighting. Hitting somebody in the face with my fist. Ever. Only crime. But I can't even go to Philly. I can't go to Texas. I can't go nowhere. So.
You're maintaining your innocence.
I'm maintaining my innocence. Because I'm loud. I didn't shut up. But I didn't think they was going to take it this serious. Me keep talking out, I didn't think it was going to be a matter of life and death. People know I didn't do this. They say it right now. They still say Tupac Shakur, rape charge. I'm not convicted of no rape charge. I want to make that real clear. My charge was sexual abuse, forcibly touching the buttocks. That's what they charged me. I'm innocent of that, but that's what I'm in jail for. We just gotta be smarter and sharper, or they're gonna start taking away each and every person that steps forward to do anything positive for the community. So that's why you be wondering why everybody wanna live a negative lifestyle. It's safer. Got the whole world fearing me, you know what I'm saying? At 23, weighing 160 pounds, you know what I'm saying? And I ain't even started. I haven't even rolled my plan out yet, and they scared. I got the vice president know who I am, the president, every cop in every city, you know what I'm saying? And I haven't even started working out a plan.
Me, but it goes down my family tree. You know what I'm saying? It's in my veins to fight back. And I'm attesting to my niggas is the same way. You know what I'm saying? So when it comes down to that, that's what happened. You know, you put any dog or any person in the corner, and that's when you get the craziest fights. That's when you get that strongest left jab and that hook and that super cross and all that shit. Knock out. So whatever it takes.
Tupac, how have you on a personal level survived all the arrests, all the controversial things, all the headlines saying, is this man crazy or not?
By my faith in God, by my faith in the game, and by my faith in all good things come to those that stay true. You know what I'm saying? And it was happening to me for a reason. You know what I'm saying? I was noticing shit. I was punching the right buttons, and it was happening. So it's no problem. You know, I mean, it's a problem, but I'm not finna let them know. I'm finna go straight through, head to the sky, and if they wanna give me more, I go do more. I keep fighting it, you know what I'm saying, until the last time. And if it comes down to me just getting one of my gats and emptying fire, these motherfuckers is a suicide on my way to San Quentin, then that's how it'll be. But I'm hoping that I could do it every other way but that way.
Ideas as who you think assassinated Park, any suspicions about anything at all, because I know a lot of people have their own theories and so forth. But what is Mupreme Shakur's views on who assassinated Park?
Cops.
Can you expand on that?
Out some way cops have something to do.
Can you give more detail as to when you say cops?
No, I can't, because if I could, then, maybe it's jail, but...
Yeah. I see.
Dirty cops.
and a member of Tupac Shakur's entourage, a witness to the shooting that left the rapper mortally wounded, has himself been killed. The murder on Sunday is further complicating an investigation already hindered by uncooperative witnesses. UPN's Sue Keenan has the story.
He was a rapper who toured with Tupac Shakur. 19-year-old Yafeu Fula was shot in the head early Sunday morning on the third floor of the housing project where he was visiting his girlfriend. She found him slumped on the hallway floor, said he'd made a joke as he answered the door.
He said, yeah, what if somebody come to kill me? And he said, we all started laughing, like, just get the door. And then he came and opened and came to the door.
And then you heard the gunshot.
Yafeu Fula was a name that a lot of people have thrown back in our faces that we were derelict in doing things. Yafeu Fula was interviewed the night of the shooting. Yafeu Fula gave a statement. People say we never interviewed him. He was interviewed. And the big thing is everybody says that he said he could identify the shooter. No, he did not. He never said that to us. He said he might be able to identify the driver. That is what he said. We tried to re-interview him. The problem was, this is a big country. People go wherever, you know, we don't have tracking devices on them. So we have to depend on people that we know we can get in touch with to try and reach out to them. Malcolm Greenidge said he could identify the shooter. We finally track him down to set up a re-interview. And he says, I'm not going to look at any photos because I can't identify him. Yeah, we got beat up in the LA Times over that. And I'm thinking, okay, put up or shut up, Ace.
Motherfuckers better watch they back and take it easy. I'm living in the danger zone and learning lessons from the game. And some niggas was gone when the frame was on. I'm getting threatened in balls daily. They're ghetto in the...
And the people in politics we address. Always a difference. Politicians are hypocrites. They don't wanna listen. If I'm insane, it's for
me. Now I'm the last motherfucker breathing.
Woke up with 50 enemies plotting my death. All 50 seeing visions of me shot in the chest. Couldn't rest, nah, nigga, I was stressed. Had me creeping round corners, homie sleeping in my vest. Shit, I'm like a hostage.
This wicked land underhanded hits a blade. Scams of plot over grams of rocks. And undercover agents die by the random shot. Scams are plotted over grams of rock. Outlaws, motherfuckers die by a random shot.
going through my mind, I get sweaty. They act like I sequestered the crime, but forget it, cause one they accept it. Say no to drugs, but the government's kept it. Running through our community, killing the unity. The war on drugs is a war on you and me. And yet, they say this is the home of the free. You ask me, it's all about hypocrisy. The Constitution, you know it is. You should be scared. You should be running. You should be trying to silence me. Huh? But you cannot, it's my turn to come. Just as you rose, you will fall. By my hands. America. You reap what these niggas got me. Cellular calls are being traced. Sim surveillance silently, but hard times never catch me slipping. Fuck authorities, they wonder why minorities be bitching. Shit, kamikaze, hoping that none of the spies find me. That's why we bye-bye daily, knowing cops trimming. But why cry float? They'll never take me alive, I'm getting strong. These sorry bastards wanna kill me in my sleep. Until they kill me, I'll be living this life. I know you feel me. Let them understand it's a family thing. I hate the feds. Tupac got your back, who can stop the hit? And even with these cops that they send for me, new friends, one of them dead. Probably be murdered for the shit that I said. I bring the real, be a
I ain't never just tripped and pitched it. Just looked at the whole situation, cause once you look at it, you know, really do. They don't give a fuck about us. Is this basis? Some say expect Illuminati, take my body to sleep. The feds is watching, niggas plotting to get me. Will I survive? Will I die? Come on, let's picture the possibility, giving me charges. Lawyers making a grip. Let me like it's a thug nigga till the day I die. I know y'all watching. I know y'all got me in the scope. Till the day I die. Got me on the surveillance, huh?
All eyes on me,
but I'm knowing.
12 gauge only a twisted. The government is getting shady, and therefore enemies trip. Me and you against the nation, whispering while we conversating, cause niggas died over information. How much more can we take? Expect us all to break. The world ain't ready for us yet, so let's make Clinton pay. They never wanted us to make it.
Hey, now, okay.
They wanna bury me, I'm worried. I'm losing my can't have to save up. My next door neighbors having convo with undercovers. Put a surprise. Everybody's dying in my next. Who can I trust? Will they be G's and then look at me before they bust? Or will they kill me while I'm sleeping? Shoot in the head, look for a baller. Getting suspicious of this bitch, the line's busy every time I call her. Nancy's telling me to visit. Who else is home? I check the house before I bone, so we all alone. And boy, shit, I better get you high. They wonder why I'm hard to kill, hard to let it go. I got my nigga dog, lyrics so deadly. When they come to get me, bring an army. And outlaw thematic shots ring out on every block. They putting hits out on politicians, even cops. I ain't lying, they
balls when we ride, get me high.
They fucked up when they rob me. Put a thug out, niggas running on E. I know the law, hit me deadly, they coming for me. Outlaws, thug, be real. But now they petrified bitches, I'm trying to be strong. They sending armies out to bomb me, listen to wrong. The only political contracts and bloodbaths. From a Tulu Shakur up in the Rockies, though they got you. I never let them stop me, the struggle continues. I'm making millions, niggas top that. They want to sit to me, they'd rather see me in the cell. Living in hell, only a few of us are lit in jail. Straight stressing, a fugitive, my occupation is under question. Wanted for investigation. And even though I'm off for death, I'ma smoke till I lose my breath, motherfuckers. Every time I see the paper, I see my picture. When the niggas getting richer, they come to get ya. It's like a motherfucking trench and giving suckers plenty space. Half these bitch niggas snitching. World we now, guns spam daily. The feds share me in hope that they can finally near me. The city will somebody save me from the systematic slavery. Got me a cup, I'm getting roughed up daily. Send me to jail, cause I rebel on what they tell me. My life's hell, got the law trying to capture me. And then the courts and the whole force after me. Got no love for these niggas, there's no need to be friends. They got me under surveillance, I swear. I'm spitting at adversaries, envious and after me. I'd rather die before they capture me. Watch me bleed, mama come here. Got your face by the phone, wanna shake it cause I can't take it. Got me living in hell, like I'm walking with a secret that'll kill me if I tell. I did a thug, it's all lies. Up in the studio, getting blown. The truest shit I ever spoke. Against all odds, hoping my true motherfuckers know this be the realest shit I ever wrote. I heard he was light-skinned stocky with a Haitian accent. Jewelry, fast cars, and he's known for flashing. Listen while I take you back and lace this rap. A real live tale about a snake.
snitch named Haitian Jack. Knew he was working for the feds. Same crime, different trials. Nigga, picture what he said. And did I mention? Promise to pay back Jimmy Hitchman in due time. I knew you bitch niggas is listening. The world is mine. Set me up, wet me up. Niggas stuck me up. Heard your guns bust, but you tricks never shut me up. Touch one of mine on everything I own.
Positive things from Tupac Shakur in the future?
Oh, no doubt. You can look forward to me doing movies, writing movies, starring in movies. Mm-hmm. Soon I want to direct them. You can look forward to me doing records, bringing on a whole bunch of groups. I already got a few now. I just signed a Death Row Records.
Mm-hmm.
I got Fatal and Felony. I got Dramacidal. Thug Life is coming back. My albums, I should be doing a couple more. The movies.
And what about the community?
I got a community project that's in the works right now. I just met with Al Sharpton, mm-hmm. Malika Shabazz, Malcolm X's daughter, a whole bunch of teachers and educators and community workers. Mm-hmm. And we're just going to start slowly but surely taking our communities back. So it's not like I'm just jawjacking or doing lip service. I don't care if don't nobody ever support me no more. I'm doing this for self. You know what I mean? But I'm saying is that measure a man by his actions fully from the beginning to the end. Don't take a piece out of my life or a song out of my music and say this is what I'm about, because you know better than that.
That's real. That's so real. I made a metamorphosis. I'm a new person today, because I used to strongly and honestly, I feel like I could represent my generation so much, because I honestly did not care whether I lived or died. But now, I cannot die with people thinking I'm a rapist or a criminal. I can't leave until this is straight. You know, I'm not suicidal. I can't go until y'all really know what time it is. And then after that, boom, it's all over. And we can see, you know, how this should fall. But that's how it is. And the reason being is because if I can't live free, if I can't live with the same respect as the next man, I don't want to be here. Because God has cursed me to see what life should be like. If God wanted me to be this person and be happy here, he wouldn't let me feel so oppressed. He wouldn't let me feel so trampled on. You know what I'm saying? He wouldn't let me think the things I think. So I feel like I'm doing God's work. You know what I'm saying? Just because I don't have nothing to pass around for people to put money in the bucket don't mean I ain't doing God's work. I feel like I'm doing God's work. You know what I'm saying? Because these ghetto kids ain't God's children. And I don't see no missionaries coming through this.
I would tell each and every person out there, don't forget about that clicking up thing, you know what I mean? Be to yourself. Stay to yourself. Trust nobody. Trust nobody.
After dog.
You know what I mean? Straight up. My closest friends did me in. My closest friends, my homies, people who I done took care of their whole family. I done took care of everything for them, looked out for them, put them in the game, everything turned on me. Fear is stronger than love. Remember that. Mm-hmm. Fear is stronger than love. All the love I gave didn't mean nothing when it came to fear. So it's all good. But I'm a soldier. I always survive. I constantly come back. You know what I mean? Only thing that can kill me is death. That's the only thing that'll ever stop me is death. And even then, my music will live forever.